Kenny Swart family, and probably Grace Swart family. Well, last week I made a video about self-love, using my life experience and anything that was on my heart that I feel will help anyone. And while I was doing that, I realized that a lot of my healing were one-on-one with God, because at the time I didn't attend church. And I feel like God was just waiting on me. So I don't feel like I found God. I feel like he was waiting on me to just give in to him. And it was something that I always fought, because I believe we all have some connection to God, especially if you were brought up knowing God in some form. So say, for example, with my mom, she used to send us to church. Even if she didn't come to church with us, we had to get ready and go to church on Sundays. And I feel like that created some foundation unconsciously, because I rebelled a long time ago. But somehow I knew that there were a God, because I remember always blaming him when something went wrong for me. Anyways, I want to let you guys know how, when I look back, how I knew somehow I didn't love myself. And so I would say these are some signs that I saw in myself that I figure out, like, yeah, you definitely did not love or value who you are. And you may not do this, like, be like, oh, I don't like myself. Like, you may not even know that you're not in love with you. And I feel like if you are not in love with you, it's impossible for you to truly love someone, because you have to love yourself before you're able to give true love to someone. And when I say true love, I don't mean like love where there's no problems. I feel like when you find who you are and you're at peace with who you are, and you've found way to express, well, if you're found, what's the word? Positive ways to express how you're feeling, you're able to love better and differently. So say, for example, if I use myself, when I used to say I'm in love or I love someone, if this person got me angry, or I shouldn't say if this person got me angry, because I feel like if I get angry, that is my choice to get angry. And how I behave when I'm angry, that is my responsibility. So if I say you got me angry, I believe that's a lie. I chose to get angry for what was done. So someone did something and I got angry. I got angry. The thing that they done angered me, but they did not get me angry. I hope I'm making sense. Yeah. And how I react is not their responsibility. They do not have my mind, my body. So I can't say to them, you made me react like that. If I choose to hit someone because I'm angry, that is my responsibility. I did it. I hit you because I got angry. So first of all, if you're angry and you say, look what you've made me done, look what you did, something is wrong. You're not ready to take responsibility for what you are doing. And if you cannot see what you're doing, that means if you cannot take responsibility for what you're doing, you're unable to make changes. You're unable to reflect because you didn't do it. If you hit someone, but in your mind you say they made me do it, you're unable to take responsibility for your actions because they made you do it. Not, oh, I got upset and I did that and I need to take responsibility and reflect and see how can I handle that situation differently if there's a next time. So anyways, this video is on how do you know. So that is one example, unable to really say I messed up. So taking responsibility for your own behavior, especially if it is negative. I would say one more thing, you're highly dependent on someone or other people to feel whole. So, and I'm basing all these things off of myself. So for example, if you were in a relationship and this relationship breaks down, you are unable to go a couple of months healing without someone else. So you have to replace that person who made you feel whole. And this is what I'm saying. So you're with someone, you and that person break up, and you find someone else, and all of a sudden you feel that wholeness again. Okay, you and that second person relationship break down, you can find someone else, and that feeling is gone. So when you break up, you feel empty. There's no point of being alive. There's no point of carrying on with your life, your day. Everything is that, just no point. But then someone else come, not the same person, and all of a sudden you feel filled up again. So it doesn't have to be the same person that fill you. Yeah, that's one thing. If you're highly dependent on others to feel completed, and it might not be a person, it could be a drug. And when I say drug, it doesn't have to be illegal drug. It could be pills, you know, that you're ODing on. You're taking when you don't need them, like painkillers, alcohol, you know. So these stuff are showing that you have some form of emptiness that you're using substance or people to fill. And it could be that you're dependent on one person. Yeah, you're obsessed with them. That one person fill that void. Okay. Another thing is that, like for me, I had to like look a certain way to feel good. So I had this saying of doll up. I need to go and doll up. If I didn't doll up, I wouldn't feel good about myself. Okay, say for example, today I have on no makeup. Back then, that would have been very impossible for me to make a video and confidently speak without no makeup, without a nice outfit, jewelry, I feel like I was using those things to hide myself. And so far, we have, you know, we need others to fill our void. We use other things to cover up what we're feeling. So substance, jewelry, makeup, drugs. Unable to take responsibility for negative behaviors. So if you cannot take responsibility for your behavior, you're unable to reflect and make steps to change. And I would say if you're highly critical of others, or it can be highly critical of yourself. So I feel like if you're unhappy with yourself, you can either do one thing or another. You can really criticize other people, like you always find flaws in other people. Yeah, that can be just you knowing that yourself have flaws unconsciously, but reflecting it on other people. You can either reflect on yourself, so everything about yourself, there's something wrong with everything about yourself. So if I look back, I think I used to do both. I think you take criticism really too hard. So even if someone is lovingly criticizing you, you take it serious. You do not see the love or the reason for their criticism, and it can really stress you out. Like you keep replaying that criticism in your head. Okay, and I think one more thing to show that you don't value and love yourself, you doubt yourself a lot. And if you doubt yourself, that open a place where Anyone can treat you anywhere, any type of way. Anyone can talk to you anyway and treat you anyway. That's that, like that. If you think of abusive relationship and why people stay in it, because they don't feel like they can or they deserve better. Yeah, so they can stay in that abusive environment. So these are not everything, but these are some stuff to look at yourself and check and be like, oh, okay. And I think one of the most important one is highly dependent on others. If you do not love yourself and have self peace and self love, it also shows in your behavior. And I can say the way you treat people. One, you can be very withdrawn from society and social group. You can be very withdrawn. You don't have a place for yourself. And the other is how you speak to people, how you process other people, how you get along with other people. Not to say you'll get along with everyone, but everyone has to be able or are able to communicate in a proper way with other people. And if you're unable to do that, you have a lot of self-healing to do. There's one thing that I'm very exposed to is that I have Jamaican. Well, both my parents are Jamaican. Even though I'm born in the Cayman Islands, I know that I'm a Jamaican. My blood is Jamaican. It's like a Ghanaian or Nigerian being born in London or America. They were born somewhere else, but their bloodline is what it is. They cannot say, I'm just American. You were born in America. You were born in England, but your blood, your DNA, your biological makeup is Nigerian or Ghanaian or Jamaican for myself. And so one thing that I hear a lot from Jamaicans is, I don't like Jamaicans. And what make it worse if they say it in powwow? Me don't like Jamaicans. To me, that just don't make sense. I don't get it. I can't process it, but okay. You don't like yourself. I don't like black people. Then you don't like yourself. I don't like this. But when you say you don't like this and you look at yourself, you're saying, I hate myself. I don't like myself. So I used to be someone who'd be like, I don't like Jamaicans. But I grew out of it because I realized if I don't like them, I don't like myself, you know. And it's a mindset that we have to grow out of and we have to develop, because I have to love Jamaicans because I am. Yeah. And they're good, and I realize that they're good and they're bad everywhere. And what I say to my husband, which he knows, there are good Jamaicans. Some people just happens to meet more of the ones that gave them a negative thought towards them. Like I told my husband this story when I came, why I was so afraid of Africans, because I used to just have really bad and strange experience with them. And my first experience with one is that she said something in her native language and she grabbed my hand, and at the time I was pregnant with my firstborn in the buggy, and she wouldn't let me go. I didn't know what she was saying, and that really, you know, and I don't think at the time I was one to scare, that frightened the living life out of me. Another one, I was chased on the high street by another African person, speaking in his language and telling me that I'm from Africa and that I am from one of the royal family there. And I was saying, no, I'm not, but he thought I was lying because he said I look like that person, but I was telling him I'm not. Another experience is that when I was in an interracial relationship, I used to get screwed a lot. That's a whole nother topic. Me and my husband just could not agree with this topic, but now I think we're on the same page. I used to get screwed and approached and disrespected because I had mixed race kids and I was in interracial relationship. Not that it's just Africans that I experienced bad red. I also experienced negative behavior and experience with white people. So as I said, there's good and bad in everyone, in every culture, in every country. It's just finding the good and hopefully having good experience. Okay, to why I'm saying all this. We are all able to heal. And I think sometimes there's people like me who need to go through the fire. And there's also people who learn from experience to others. Like, they don't have to experience it. They can see someone experience it and then make the right decision. And then there's just destiny where you just have to get burnt. How I heal. I found my healing through Jesus Christ. That is how I found my healing. And when I say through Jesus Christ, I became suicidal, depressed, and I cannot really explain that in this video because it'd be too long, but I'll make a video. And through that experience, I had no choice but to cry out to God. I remember being on the high street, just walking and crying. People looking at me like, what's wrong with this girl? And I was walking and crying and talking to God. So to, if you were looking at me, you think I'm talking to myself. Crazy. Through crying out to God, I found myself isolated. Like, I could have been in a crowd, but I wouldn't have been in the crowd, if that makes sense. So I could be surrounded by people, but I would feel alone. So I found myself isolated mentally and sometimes physically by myself. And no matter how much people would be around me, I would still feel empty and alone. So through this isolation, I feel with the help of the Holy Spirit, I was led a lot to read the Word of God, the Bible, pray, and to listen to people of God and like T.D. Jakes. It was mostly T.D. Jakes, to be honest. And I feel like he's a teacher for those who are broken. And a lot of people do not, well, some people do not believe T.D. Jakes is a man of God. And I cannot say whether he is or not. What I can say is that his word, God used him to be my pastor when I wasn't in church. And his preaching built me up so much to I no longer needed milk. So when the Bible say milk, I was no longer a baby. I was then a toddler and could move forward to go into church with the help of my husband by force. And then eventually learning to do it on my own, learning to be like, oh, I need to get ready and go to church today because church was benefiting me. I was changing. I was looking at things differently. So this is the way that I healed. And this did not take a couple of months. I would say my healing to where I was in a place of sanity, of wholeness, of peace, of joy, took over 3 years. And I feel like I had a lot in me. And I didn't know that there was so much anger and pain in me. And not everything is healed at one time. God heal with things one by one. So you have different levels, different categories of healing that you need. And little by little, one by one, if you allow God, he will do it. Also, he also used people to develop you and to help you through your healing. I feel one person God truly helped with my healing and development was my husband. And sometimes he did not use him like as the person to come and be like speaking to me. He would do something like, I felt like with my husband, I was still in that mindset of making, he made me whole. When I got what he made me. And so for that, I believe God removed him from me twice. Where we were married and he had to leave the country, or it was work where he had to go far away for work. And he used this situation where I would learn not to cling onto someone or substances, because at the time I still drank. So my point of this video is to say, are you whole? Are you whole? And it's dangerous to not be whole, because then you seek sources to make you whole. But I'm here to tell you, there is a God, there is a Savior, and there is a helper, yeah, that can help you to find you. And there is peace, and there's wholeness, and there's joy. There is a place of happiness where you don't have to depend on your surrounded or people, but upon your God. You depend on your God and your God only. Yeah, so I want to encourage you. If you are ready to find yourself, if you are ready to be whole, I want to encourage you. It does not happen overnight, but you gotta make that choice that I gotta take myself out of this environment, out of this mindset. Start reading books, your Bible, watching positive motivators, sermons, and praying and depending on God, and you will eventually see who you are in Christ. Father, I commit this video unto you. I also commit anyone who's watching this video to you, Lord. Father, as you have delivered so many people, myself included, I pray for deliverance upon this person in the name of Jesus. I pray for your deliverance in Jesus' name. I pray that you teach them to submit and commit to you, so that you can also submit and commit unto them in the name of Jesus Christ. I cover their mind, their body, and their spirit in the blood of Jesus. I pray for healing, deliverance, and wholeness in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, I call upon the name of Jesus Christ for this person. I call upon the name of Jesus Christ for this person. I call upon the name of Jesus Christ for your child. Deliver them and show them who they are in you. In Jesus' name, amen. I want to leave you with three scriptures. First one is John 3:16. For God so loved the world as to give his only begotten Son, that whosoever believe in him may not perish, but have life everlasting. For God so loved you that he gave his only Son. If you believe in him, he'll give you life and life everlasting. My second scripture is Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. So God has plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. I love that scripture. God wants to give you hope, and he also wants to give you a beautiful future. And my third scripture is John 10:27. My sheep listen to my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. If you are a child of God, whether you're in the world or not, you hear the voice of God. But you also need to know that you are a child of God. That is your Father's voice, and you need to follow Him and be obedient. You can hear God's voice through your spirit, through your inner man, and through reading the Word, or through other people speaking the Word of God that says something like, this person is speaking to me. Yeah? In quietness, in silence, where there's not everyone in your ears speaking to you and telling you negative things especially, you can hear God's voice. So just pray and depend on Him. And I know sometimes saying pray and depend is hard, but God is with His children. And if you confess and surrender your life to God, you will see Him move mightily. I believe that because He's done it for me. So if you want to surrender your life to God, repeat after me. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I ask for your forgiveness. I ask that you cleanse me with the blood of Jesus. Father, I pray and I confess with my mouth and my heart that I believe in Jesus. I believe He died for my sin. I believe He died on the cross and raised up on the third day. Father, have mercy upon me. Forgive me and fill me with your spirit and show me your ways. Father, I surrender to you right now. Father, have mercy. Have mercy and add me to the record of everlasting life in heaven. In Jesus' name, add me to the book of life in the name of Jesus Christ. Show me and teach me your ways, Jesus, and show me the plans you have for me, the plans of hope and expected. And oh God, I want to be your sheep. I want to hear your voice in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you guys. I hope that you are encouraged and blessed by this video. If you are, remember to share, remember to like, and remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel or me, my husband's YouTube channel. I will make sure I put that information as a link or in the video. God bless you.